winter wonderland of Winterberg in Germany's Hochsauerland. We're not too far east of the industrial heartland based around Kern and the Ruhr Valley, and in one of the traditional sliding centres of our winter sports. Hello, everybody. Welcome back to our coverage of this fifth race weekend for the BMW IBSF Women's Skeleton World Cup, as we have 21 sleds from 12 nations, including for the first time this season, Canada and the USA on our start list, getting into the first of our two heats on this Winterberg track. And to use a well-earned phrase, it's easy to get down, it's hard to get down fast. This track is well known to many European sliders and worldwide sliders. It's often where sliders have their very first experience, because after a fairly flat start, it is a gentle start to this track. Little zero kink before we get down the long run into turn one. Listen to the wind speed. We always say how slow it is in these first few corners, but if the wind was whistling past your ears like that and you're on a toboggan on a hillside, you'd be thinking, I'm pretty good here. Out of corner three, little uphill rise into four, and then down here we are in corner five, dropping about 2.5 to 3 stories past the donut stand, closed this season, into six and then seven, the Kreisel, 270 degree, big pressure, two and a little bit on the exit there, and then through corner eight, big left-hander, corner nine. Little dink here, and then corner 11. Big right-hander through the lower labyrinth, 12, 13, and then 14, which goes on forever uphill to the line. Easy to roll off the finish and across the line. The track record set by Germany's Sara Wimmer. That was in the Europa Cup race in November of last year. So that's a new record this season. It may be broken today. We'll have to wait and see. No track records in the men's competition. Janine Flock leads our World Cup points. And this fifth race of the season, see her going for her fifth straight medal. She's had three wins, one win for Elena Nikitina. And Kimberly Bosulai, second in the points, has not been off the podium all year. Kimberly Boss last year, because of injury, barely made the cut. That's what a change around that health has given her. There's Janine Flock with one of her Latvian coaches, Elena Nikitina of Russia. She missed the last race in Innsbruck. And there is Kimberly Boss. India Tirada of Latvia. And there is Yulia Kanakina. Even with the masks, it's fairly easy to spot some of these athletes. Elizabeth Meyer for Canada. In Innsbruck, she was the sole North American slider. Now we have Canada and the USA with their regular World Cup spots filled. Now, there will be a slight delay to proceedings. There is a bit of an issue with the red and green traffic light system to start the athletes at the top of the track. So let's take a look at our start draw. 21 sleds, which means one won't get through into the second heat. Alessia Kripa, Elizabeth Meyer, and Laura Dees start them off ahead of the top 10 in the world. Nikitina, Hermann, Neiser, Fernstedt, Lerling, our points leader, Janine Flock. And then behind her, Valentina Margaglio and Kimberly Boss. Then Endia Taralda. And looking down the order, the newcomer to the field, Jacqueline Laberge from Canada, making her first ever World Cup start. Katie Ulender, her first since before the Winter Olympic Games. And Kendall Wessenberg also returns for the USA. Well, what started as a slightly snowy morning has become a little bit of a foggy afternoon. Winterberg, otherwise known as Rainyberg, stroke the Dutch Alps. No skiing at the moment because of the COVID crisis. Let's hope that there is no snow either. Getting race five for the BMW IBSF Women's Skeleton World Cup underway in Winterberg in Germany is Italy's Alessia Kripa. Her first World Cup start here in Winterberg. She has got experience of this track in the lower category of sliding, the Europa Cup. The 20-year-old at the age of 15. And she raced here in the Junior World Championships last February, finished a strong eighth place. And her World Cup best, 13th place in Eagles in race two, the last before Christmas. She's been getting better all season. This is her sixth ever World Cup start. And she is our rabbit. She will give us an indication of perhaps what to expect from the track. Running uphill to turn four and then dropping down into five. Very flat here. Once you get out of the curve of corner five, walking up the hill, you've broken the back of the incline. And then turn seven, the big Kreisel, two pressures and a little bit at the end, but she gets a good exit. And Alessia started a World Cup career at the end of last season, raced in the World Championships in Altenburg. And if you remember, her first run in the World Championships, pulled on the strap to tighten the helmet, ripped it off the helmet. Now, she wasn't able to start, and for a moment, it looked like her World Championships was over, but she managed to borrow a helmet, go back and commence her World Championship campaign at the end of the first heats. So, making rules up as they went along there, I'm not sure there was actually a rule for that. So 58.28 the downtime, 57.26 is the record. Don't think we're in record pace today, but she's a second off. So 5.46 at the start, and that was a pretty smooth looking run from Alessia Krieper. So the Italian first out of the start blocks. Next up in her 40th World Cup race, Lisbeth Meyer of Canada, the 26-year-old, spending her winter with husband Benny Meyer in Innsbruck and the family. Made her World Cup return in Innsbruck for the final two races of 2020 after maternity leave, giving birth to baby Hendrix just over 14 months ago. Three World Cup wins, two of which came in her first season, and nine podiums, including silver on her debut, 5.43. She'll freely admit that she's still a little race rusty, I think, and perhaps not physically at her peak either, but that will come. 500s ahead of Alessia Krieper. The Wonder Woman logo on the helmet. She knows the track well. She's raced here before on a number of occasions. 92.5, so better speed than the Italian. Hundredths up. And this could be a half-second advantage at the bottom of the track. So far, seventh and fifth in the two races in Innsbruck. And across the line she comes, 57.85. So 43 hundredths ahead of Alessia Krieper. Now, where is that going to leave her in the overall pecking order? Bit of a ho-hum, so-so hand signal there. Have to see what Liz Meyer has at the end of this. Coach Tuffy Latour, the head of the US program, helping the Canadian athletes as well as his own down there with the sleds. Big bump off the zero kink. You don't want to get that much of the corner. That just slows you down. You've worked so hard to get those precious few hundreds at the start, and then you bump them away in the zero. Drops a little low into the gutter in 11. Allowed her Bromley sled a little bit too much leeway there. Mommy Rita, Grandma Rita, I guess, is now Winterberg, but again, not at the track. Nobody there apart from absolutely vital support services. Laura Dees of Great Britain, third starter, 49th World Cup start for our Olympic bronze medalist from Pyeongchang. One win, four podium finishes for her. Her European Championship best, because this is the European Championships, two fifth place finishes. 100th behind at the start, 5.44. Laura's best ever World Cup race here back in 2015 saw her just off the podium in fourth spot. Finished in 13th place in last year's race. Basically, since her debut here at World Cup, it has been getting steadily trickier for Laura to find the pace. And in a parallel, she was also 13th in the European Championships, which were in Sigulda last February. Second best speed. A distinctive whistle from the Blackrock sled. 300s away, but better speed in the final corner. Can she hold it across the line? Hits the wall hard, 700s back, 57.92. Okay, so very little at all between two of our very experienced sliders, Liz Meyer and Laura Dees. Just 0.07 of a second in it. And much less of corner zero, and that helps keep the speed alive, even if she did get a little bump over onto the wall down to turn one. Here in 11, drops a little less far into the ditch, but there's that big compression bump when you ride up on the second pressure. And then across the line, very easy to roll off the final corner. Laura Dees from Wrexham in Clwyd originally. Next up, Elena Nikitina of Russia. The 28-year-old has 10 World Cup wins and 8 podiums. She was a bronze medalist here 3 seasons ago. And she is a double European champion, including winning the gold medal in Sigulda in February 2020. This is our defending European champion. Russia already with a European gold in the hands of Alexander Tretiakov. 14 years after he had previously won European Championship gold. 62 kilometers now, fastest start and best speed. And after a couple of fallow seasons, last year Elena Nikitina really started firing on all 8 cylinders again. She has not stopped. Silver in the second race in Sigulda, gold in the first in Innsbruck. Then she, Kanakina, Chetikov and Chegubov all went off to Altenburg to do some world championship prep. She's had a fairly meagre time in the Worlds last year in Altenburg. I don't want to make the same mistake again. So she's dropped a little further down the World Cup standings than you'd expect Elena to be. Third best speed with the lead at the line, though, by 0.25 seconds. That's a really nice looking run. Steered it a lot in the final corner. And that might be a little bit of a coin toss, whether you cut ice by steering to avoid the outside wall, or whether you don't cut ice by not steering and risk not only running up the wall, but also digging the bumpers of the sled into the track as you cross the line. Again, not a bad run through the little zero dink. A little late on the crossover there. She had to work hard for it. And in 11, look at the big bump again as you rise. She misses most of that. Elena Nikitina, our European champion, is the leader. 5 sleds down and 16 to come. Heat 1 of the BMW IBSF Women's Skeleton World Cup, race 5 in Winterberg in Germany. And after our European champion has had her run, Tina Hermann of Germany, the world champion, has hers. Elena Nikitina, the current leader, in her 54th World Cup start. Tina here in her 53rd, from which she has 10 wins and 17 podiums. She's had 2 wins and a silver medal here in 5 outings in Winterberg. Doesn't start as quickly as the Russian, but the Germans know how to manufacture speed down the bottom. There's no other word for it. 48 hundredths back, and you think now, okay, it's done, she's gone, there's not a hope, and suddenly the gaps come down. Little busy from 6 into 7, but it's below the Kreisel, but she's gonna make her speed. Fastest of all, and this is what Hermann does, this is what Lerling does, it's what Sophia Griebel used to do so well as well. Gaps down from 48 hundredths to 17 hundredths. Best speed, she could be close at the line. She leads by 2 hundredths. Drama across the line as she rides the wall high. And again, the jury's out. Maybe not in the minds of the Germans, but maybe in the minds of the Russians. Do you steer hard off 14 or do you let it fly? Either way, it's gonna cost you a little bit. It's how much it costs you. And Tina, as ever, beating herself up at the bottom of the track. Look at that little toe steer there just to get the nose of the sled down. And here we go in 11. She's got faith in that line, hasn't she? And the final corner, high up the wall there. She didn't dig the bunks of the sled into the wall, and that's good news. She is our leader by a whisker. Tina Herman leads, Elaine Nikita and Elizabeth Meyer, five sleds down in Winterberg. Race five of the BMW IBSF Women's Skeleton World Cup. Six of our 21 starters is 20-year-old German Hannah Neiser. Hasn't had a World Cup race here in Winterberg before. This is only the fifth World Cup of her nascent career. Youth Olympics silver medalist in Lillehammer 2016. She's got plenty of heritage. She was also the bronze medalist in the 2020 Junior Worlds here. Out starts the current leader, her teammate Tina Herman. She is short on knowledge of this track. She only has three official races here in Winterberg. But just before Christmas in Innsbruck, the final race of 2020, she claimed her World Cup best finish of eighth place. 300s behind now. How close can she get? Best speed into the Kreisel, better than Herman. Tina Herman was fastest of all the speed traps down after the first one. She's just behind Tina at the moment by 300s. This is going to be very close for Hannah Neiser. 700s back. First to second is 200s of a second. First to third, 2700s. She's in third. It's now down to 900s. That's a good run. That's a very nice looking run from Hannah Neiser. Only Tina Herman has started slower than Hannah. And again, this all goes back to the question of, do you need a fast start? Well, you need a start. Does it have to be the fastest in the field? Not if you can drive. It doesn't hurt. But there's a massive fixation among certain branches of the coaching staff on starts. German skeleton team, British skeleton team are not immune to that. Next up, a former German slider, now sliding for the Czech Republic, 24-year-old Anna Fernstedt, originally from Königssee in Bavaria, Berchtesgaden. The 2019 Junior World Champion, now starting her 13th World Cup race for the Czech Republic, the same number that she started for Germany. Two World Cup medals for Germany, best of fourth as a Czech slider, and a lot of corner zero, but she controls it well. Now, this is where her German tutelage should really help her. Best here, ninth place in 2017, and that was as a German slider. So let's see what she can produce. She's 2/10 back off the seventh fastest start. Speed is good, but the gap is out to 3/10 of a second. She needs real magic down here. Third best sled, but she's only seventh on the split times. 4100s, the gap is growing. Still third best speed. It's not going to be enough. It puts her in sixth position behind Laura Dees. Duff Gibson there with the Utah Olympic Park green buff, not only coaching the Canadians, but helping out Anna Fernstedt. Czech Republic, you know, same letter of the alphabet. The smaller nations often buddy up with athletes and coaches and support staff from bigger nations. Well, not the best run for Anna Fernstedt. Let's see what the second heat produces for. Looking a little harder than she might have liked all the way down. So, big smile under the face mask of Anna Fernstedt. And next up, her former teammate, Jacqueline Lerling. Jacka from Winterberg, from BSC Winterberg, the sliding club here. 43rd World Cup race for Jacka, Olympic silver medalist at 23 years old, World Cup champion from last year. She's got 11 wins and 16 podiums, so 27 medals from 43 races. That is Alan Prost Ayrton Senna strike rate. She was the 2017 European champion on this track. It was a big year for her because she was the world champion that year as well. So she starts quicker than teammate Tina Herrmann. She's 400s in front. The nature of this Winterberg track is that traditionally there are tiny margins between the sliders, 400s up to 400s back. And you saw the little skid from four into five and on the exit of five. Jeff Payne, I beg your pardon, not Doug Gibson. Thank you, Rita. Head down from Lurling. Trusting her feel of home ice. 700s back, but best speed at the bottom. How close will she be? Does she leave Tina Herrmann? No, 600s. The race is on. 300s behind Hannah Neiser. Ahead of Hannah Neiser, rather. 400s behind Elena Nikitina, and 600s behind Tina Herrmann. So it is a very tightly packed lead group. Top four covered by 900s of a second. So Jacqueline Lurling, the hometown queen. Normally the place would be rocking with friends and family. Family almost always seem to outnumber friends. Little high in the second pressure in 11. Just an extra few centimetres to cover. She lies in third place. Now, here is our World Cup points leader. Three times a race winner this season, Janine Flock from Austria. Janine starting her 84th World Cup race, nearly as many as Tina Herrmann and Jacqueline Lurling put together. Still just 31 years of age. 9 wins, 20 podiums, a third of her career victories have come this season, and 20% of her podiums this season alone. She's a double European champion, multiple World Cup winner, and in fact, in European Championship racing, she has never been off the podium, and she currently, from a fifth best start, is up to second on the splits. This is going to be a heck of a race. 300s of a second in front of the Germans, of Germany's world champion on a German track. 200s back. It will change with every turn. She's a fraction behind on pace. How close at the line? 600s back, tied with Jacka. We now have 5 sleds covered by 900s of a second. And to put that into perspective, 700s of a second is what it takes a human eye to blink. How can they be so close? Different bodies, different starts, different sleds, different runners, different setup. The only thing that remains the same, largely, on each run, is the ice itself. How can they all be so different and so the same? Just beggars belief. Next up, Valentina Margaglio, the young Italian lying sixth in this year's World Cup rankings. 27 years old, World Championship bronze medalist in the mixed team event in Altenburg. Tied Anna Fernstedt for 11th place in the race here in January 2020. So we're looking at Anna currently being in 8th spot ahead of Alessia Crippa. The more experienced of the two Italians will be looking to beat her teammate at least 5:25. Good getaway from Valentina Margaglio, the fastest start of the competition so far. Climbing uphill. Out of four, dropping back down towards turn five. 2700s is her lead over Tina Herrmann. And to put that into perspective, Liz Meyer at the bottom of the track in sixth is 2700s behind, but now it's all going away. She's working too hard. She does not know this track intimately the way that the Germans do. And her big start is undone. She's struggling for control in the lower labyrinth. Only the 10th best speed at the line. 9th place, 58.20. And that is ahead of teammate Alessia Kripa, but it's not a tie with Anna Fehrenstedt that she tied with last year. So Valentina Margaglio looking here in the Kreisel, waving, watch the toes. She's trying hard not to drag them, but they're dragging all the way through. And again here in 11, tap dancing her way in, looking for the second pressure, trying to steer it down with her head. You're so exposed. The old melon is out the front there, and your hands are down below your hips. The brain is screaming at you to be careful. 10 sleds down out of our 21 strong field. Tina Herman leads from Elena Nikitina, Janine Flock, Jacqueline Lerling, and Hannah Neiser. Well, next up is our 11th starter, Kimberly Bos of the Netherlands. The 27-year-old Dutch slider lying second in the World Cup rankings after an epic season, being cheered away at the top there by former teammate Joske LeConte, who's now helping with the coaching. 5:47 getaway. Started her career in bobsledge. She was a Youth Olympic bronze medalist in girls' bob. Then converted to skeleton, best here, seventh place back in 2017. Then she struggled with injury, particularly last season. 3 second places, 2 third places in her World Cup career, and 4 of those medals gained this year. It's almost like this is a whole new Kimberly Bos, the 2.0, if you like. 400s up on Tina Herman. She's in the medal hunt again here, Kimberly Bos. Sled built by double European champion Kristen Bromley. 6th best speed at the bottom. How close will she be? 1900s back. So she's in the top 6. She might not make it onto the podium here for the first time this year. But last year she didn't race in Winterberg at all. Finished in 9th in the Europeans last year in Sagulda at the end of the year. But this year, it is a whole different Kim. She's healthy, she's feeling fit, and she is sliding superbly. So Kimberly Bos of the Netherlands in 6th position. Really burst on the scene here in Winterberg in the World Championships in 2015. Next up, Andia Torralda in her 5th World Cup race. Started this season in Sigulda. Lies 9th in the standings. And her first race, a bronze medal, shocked everybody, not least herself. 3rd, 11th. And then 11th and 15th in Innsbruck. So she needs to try and turn that around a little. 5:64 the getaway. 300s of a second behind leader Tina Herman. If she can keep anything like that margin down towards the bottom, she will be doing extremely well. Down to 5, what's the gap? Was 1400s, now out to 3800s of a second. So she's going to be towards the bottom of the top 20 at the end of the first heat rather than towards the top. At the moment, she's behind the two Italians, Valentina Margaglio and Alessia Kripa. And for Andia, this season will be all about learning against the very best in the World Cup. Tracks that she will have raced on before, but not in this kind of company. 56:68 for her. So 4 tenths behind Alessia Kripa. So the Latvian slider. Teammate Martins Dukurs taking a European silver medal today. Finished behind Alexander Tretiakov. The first time in 12 seasons he has not been the European champion. Try and channel all of the knowledge that she can from the Ducos family into her sliding, and the extremely talented Latvian coaches helping with that. Next up, Kim Marmans of Belgium, 24 years of age, finished in 10th place in the race here in Winterberg in the middle of January last year. And in Sigulda, finished a strong 5th place in the European Championships. If she could do that here in Winterberg, that would be a huge bonus as well. Former product of the German youth training program. She too grew up in Viesturs, started sliding there with the German team. 1600s ahead of Tina Herman. She outstarted Tina by 1800s. And Kim, another slider for whom Winterberg is fairly familiar territory. Very close to the Low Countries. That's why it's known as the Dutch Alps. You get lots of skiers here from the Netherlands in the winter. 10th best speed. She's gone from the third fastest starter out to 10th place on the splits. Not a first heat to write home about. 6th best speed at the bottom should keep her in the top 10. And it does, ahead of Anna Fernstedt by 200ths of a second in 9th place. So a good battle between two former German sliders, one of whom is now sliding for Belgium and one for the Czech Republic. 5 to 6, always a little tricky. And dropping down towards the lower part of the track, corner 11. Keeps the line nice and low, avoids the big bump on that second pressure. So Kim Marmans lying in 9th place. And next up is Yulia Kanakina for Russia, former junior world champion, now 25 years of age. Had a disaster here last year. Just a horror story, 19th place finished. Last year was a disaster for a whole bunch of athletes. Over-rotated there, getting onto the sled, almost hit the grooves. Gets away with it, 5:32 start. Had several miscued starts in the men's competition. Second best speed and the third fastest start. So not only was she quick out of block, she continued that acceleration. 3600s up on Tina Herman. Comes down a little and it's going to plummet as well. 12th best speed into the Kreisel. Russian men's sleds seem to have a decent setup, but Kanakina, whatever she's done to set her sled today, has not worked in these conditions. 2600s back. Third fastest starter. She'll be doing well to stay in the top 10. She doesn't. 58.08. And that drops her down to 11th place behind Anna Fernstedt by 200s. Kim Marmans 400s ahead of her. So, Yulia finished in 4th place in the European Championships, just out of the medals in Sigulda last year. That seems a very different world to today. Again, that second pressure. She steered away from the bump, high up in corner 11. Our third Russian slider is 24-year-old Elena Frolova. And Elena, again, making her World Cup debut this season. She raced in the Intercontinental Cup last year. That's the second tier of sliding. The 24-year-old from Moscow. World Cup best so far, 13th place, race one in Innsbruck. And she would be doing well to do that here as well, 5:43. She gets away from corner zero without too much problems. Too many problems out of two. Like a decent transition into three. Climbing up. Out of four, and then dropping down into five. She's still in the green ahead of Tina Herman, but the gap's gone from 1800s to 200s behind, and only the 13th best speed. There will be a degree of head-scratching between the first and second heats from two at least of our Russian athletes. Not sure that the track is deteriorating. Just not sure what setup they've gone with and why it's not working, but the speed is very low. Rolls off the final corner into 14th. So Elena Frolova in 14th place out of 15 sliders, and Dia Tirauda of Latvia is behind her. And Alessia Kripper ahead, 1200s distant. So plenty of opportunity for spots to move around. Low early in 11 and then hits the bump on the way back up on the second pressure. And here, big skid in the middle of the final corner and drives it down, but a little too early and hits the wall. Sixteenth of 21 starters in the field here in Winterberg, Germany, is Francis Agathe Bessart. Bessart, 21 years old. Family involved in running the track in La Plan. That's where she started as soon as she was allowed, as soon as she was old enough. Age 14, had her first trips on the skeleton sled. That was always what she wanted to do. See what she's got today. Start 5.75. Tina Herman, in contrast, started 1400s quicker. Let's see where Agathe Bessart ends up at the end of the run. 13th place in the second race in Sigulda is her best result of the season. A World Cup best day, an 11th place finish. She's not going to get that here. 16th at the start. She is currently in 16th place, trying to chase down fellow World Cup newcomer Dia Tirauda of Latvia. Bessart competing in a few races last year. So this is actually her 7th World Cup race, 5th this season. And she rolls across the line in approved style. Not approved by the coaches, maybe, but it is hanging on to the speed in the final corner. Sometimes you just take the hits. Kevin Boyer, as he said in the men's race, only three things are certain in life: death, taxes, and Boyer rolling off the final corner in Winterberg. And it's not limited to skeleton either. We've seen bobsleigh races won as sleds have rolled off Zeel Curve. Big, high, late line there, right up by the woodwork, and had to work very hard indeed to gather it all up. And then late pressure up on the big bump in 11. And not quite the victory roll, but rolls across the line. Next up for Great Britain, Ashley Pittaway. And Ashley back in the World Cup lineup again this weekend. British lineup looks like it's going to change just about every race of the season. Another who grew up sliding in Viesturs, the family live in Munich. So she grew up sliding in Viesturs at the Koenigsee track. 5.52, the 11th best start, 900s quicker than Tina Herman. She's already 2200s back. 11th best speed, that's encouraging. She's 14th on the splits, but if she can keep the speed up here, 11th best speed still, she could be creeping closer and closer to a top 10 run. Ashley with two races in Segulda, 12th and 8th under her belt this year, and across the line, 14th place. All right, so she was 11th off the blocks and 14th all the way down the track, pretty much. Yep, work to do there for the British slider. Is that right? In a good way or a bad, I'm not sure how to read that. Yes, the time is usually right. A 58.40 run for Ashley Pittaway of Great Britain. Originally from Munich in Bavaria, now lives outside Bath.
Happy birthday.
And next up is another British slider. Maddie Smith is our 18th of 21 starters. Again, Maddie with two races so far in the World Cup this season in Innsbruck, 12th in both of those. And although she is wearing BBSA clothing, she is not on a Blackrock sled. She is on a Bromley sled. And she is self-funded, self-coaching. She is finding help and assistance wherever she can. She's not officially under the British skeleton umbrella. 5.59 getaway. Again, right in the same territory as race leader Tina Herrmann. A couple of hundreds faster than the German. Already dropping into the red behind Tina by 0.06 of a second. Now for Maddie. It was her start. That was the problem, according to the British coaches. But medals aren't won in the first 50 metres. They're won at the finish line. It's the whole package that makes the difference. Half a second back in 16th place off the 13th best start. She's desperately trying to produce some good race results this year, try and fight her way back into the British programme. And across the line, 16th it is, 58.62. Our teammate Ashley Pittaway just came down 22 hundredths faster. And Maddie's going to be a little bit disappointed with being 16th ahead of only Endia Taralda and Agat Besar at the moment. And that will be enough to guarantee her a second heat. So another chance to improve. Just gets bumped away there a fraction, as we see so often, from four into five. That means you have to steer hard twice in corner five. And then 11, she gets that early hit of second pressure right up on that bump.
Happy birthday, Ollie, love you lots.
Oh, Ollie's birthday, okay, fair enough. Former British bobsledder and boyfriend. And now making her World Cup debut from Canada, Jacqueline Laberge, 36 years old, a former rugby player. She's raced here in the Intercontinental Cup. She's never raced in the World Cup before, has not started in the World Championships. So this is her first taste of the big time. Great to see her coming out onto the World Cup. A little bit of corner zero of a 5.84 getaway. Teammate Mimi Reneva, who finished in the silver medal position here last year for Canada, is rehabbing an injury, so she's not here. Jane Channel also not travelling to Europe at the moment. So Jacqueline Laberge saying that when she got the news that she'll be sliding in the World Cup, it took a week to wipe the smile off her face. Let's hope reality doesn't hit too badly here. 19th at the start, 19th at the moment. Very experienced in North American tracks, more experience in the last few years in European tracks as well. 17th best speed at the line, and she is in 19th. How far? She's 2/10 behind Agat Besar. Well, Canada without a coach on tour, and so Jeff Payne, who is coaching Anna Fernstedt for the Czech Republic, is also helping out the Canadians. Well, welcome to the World Cup, Jacqueline Laberge. Let's hope the second heat puts a smile on her face. Always tough to get your big break on a track that you're not intimate with. I'm sure she'd feel a lot more comfortable if it was on a North American circuit track. Lake Placid, Park City, Whistler. But it is what it is. She's here in the World Cup representing Canada at the highest level. Next up, Katie Ulander, 36 years of age from the USA. Caleb Smith with the sled for our 11-time World Cup winner with a further 10 podium finishes. 2012 world champion Katie making her first World Cup start since Koenigsegg, January 2018. She retired after the Games and has unretired since. She's been working her way back into the US program. Like John Daly, she had to do it the hard way, winning selection races and then re-earning her spot as a qualified World Cup athlete. So it's welcome back to Katie Ulander. 12th best start, 5:53. She's out to 14th on the splits. May just be that the track is not as quick now as it was before. Mind you, she hasn't been on the ice here in Winterberg in a while. A familiar bald eagle on the helmet. And she is going to be in the mid-teens across the line. 14th place. 600s behind Alicia Kripa, 600s ahead of Ashley Pittaway and Elena Frolova, who are tied for 15th. So no danger at all of dropping out in the second heat. Katie Ulander, one of the real fighters in sport, never mind in this sport. Big first pressure in the Kreisel, just drifted away from her a little. And here in 11, it's a pretty decent looking line. And there's the bald eagle. Well, that leaves Jacqueline LeBerge in 20th place with one to go. So Katie will make the cut in her return. What about her teammate Kendall Wessenberg? And Kendall making her first World Cup start of the season. We last saw her in action at the end of February 2020. So yes, the US have been training as much as they could in the summer, selection races, and then keeping up to speed, Lake Placid and Park City. Training is one thing and competing is another. I'm sure every single one of them is just really happy to be back. 5:77 getaway. That's the 20th start. So let's see what Kendall can produce. Just to fight her way into this field. 3,600s back. She's in 19th place on the splits. That's where she needs to be, driving her way into this race. It's her or Jacqueline LeBerge. And your money should be on Kendall. More recent experience of this track. Tenth best speed. This is a good looking run from Kendall Wessenberg of the USA. She's in the race in 19th place at the moment on the splits. Can she pick up another spot or two? Still decent looking speed. And across the line, 18th place, she's in. Jacqueline LeBerge of Canada does not get a second heat on her debut. So Kendall Wessenberg in 18th spot will get a second run. Well, this hasn't always been such a productive track for Kendall. Best result here, 12th and 10th in 2015 and 2017. Missed the cut in December 17. And then 15th and 17th in her last two World Cup outings on this track. So she needs to recover that top 10 form. But she will get a second heat. And the sleds will go again from 4 p.m. local time, 1500 UTC Greenwich Mean Time. And they will go in reverse order. Tina Hermann of Germany will defend her lead on this track. looking for career victory number 11. She is the reigning champion from last year. She's had two wins on this track. And if she can claim gold, she will also take the European Championship. And for Tina Herman, that will be a first. Tina's been closest to the gold medal in 2017 on this track, where she was bronze behind Jacqueline Lurling and Janine Flock, who will be giving her a very substantial run for her money. Don't you worry too much about that. Jacqueline LeBerge unfortunately misses the cut on her first ever World Cup outing, and that means Agathe Bessart of France will lead off the 20 sliders in the second and deciding heat from 1600 Central European, 1500 GMT. Join me, Martin Haven, and the IBSF TV crew for all the action then. Until then, take care. We'll be back in just a little under 40 minutes.